My name is Mr. Oden. I'm the school counselor, one of the school counselors at Tappan Middle School, currently serving as the 8th grade counselor. My experience with working with the Washington Area Council for Children, I think of a few words. I think of organization, effectiveness, engagement, and being well-trained. And I'm gonna break down each of these. When working with the Washington Area Council for Children representative last year, she came in extremely organized. They have a top-of-the-line curriculum for cyber safety and anti-bullying. And I was just really impressed on how she would show up on a weekly basis to work with our 7th and 8th graders. And even we even ran a second session and did it with the 6th graders, where she would have her assignments ready to go, her activities ready to go. And it was really not a lot of input that I had to, or sweat equity that I had to do from my end. She would come in, she was organized, and she was ready to go. And I'm really appreciative of that. Effectiveness and engagement, that goes right along with the organization of everything. The representative was very effective in managing the students. I was there obviously to support, to make sure that the students were well behaved and things of that nature, but she was very effective in managing the students. Really didn't need me to be present or there to kind of manage things. She had that under control. The activities and assignments was very effective. They were engaging. One of the things that really stick out to me was I believe it was anti-bullying or cyber safety Jeopardy. And students were able to not necessarily compete, but they were able to play this game where there was like a Jeopardy type board on the screen. You could pick a certain category, let's say social media for 500, and then you can answer the question and earn those points. I can't remember if they were in teams or not. I don't believe it was a competition, but I do remember playing at Jeopardy, and it was a very effective and engaging activity that the students were able to do as part of their curriculum. Again, the WACC representative at the time, she came in, she was very well-trained, she knew her stuff, she knew the curriculum, she had great ideas. In fact, one of the student-led projects that we decided to do at the end of the 7 weeks, or however long the curriculum was, the project that we decided to do was, we took on the challenge of doing an anti-bullying video to show school-wide. And this video had never been done before, but I was willing to support and make it happen. And when I tell you that the representative made it so easy for me to support her, she actually wrote out the script, wrote out the lines for each character, and I just had to play as the muscle. I came in, I recorded the process, I edited the process, I helped executively produce the video. But as far as like the grunt work, writing the script, writing what each character is going to say, deciding who's going to play each character, she had all of that down pat. So overall, working with the Washington Area Council for Children was a pleasure. What we would describe as light work, meaning that it wasn't a lot of sweat off my brow. They came in extremely effective, full of engagement, really well organized and well trained, and ultimately it made it extremely easy for me to support and just be of assistance. So what is the impact of bullying?
People bully to have control over their targets. Targets can feel helpless, angry, and alone. Those who are bullied can develop anxiety, depression, self-harm, or even take their own life. 58% of victims of bullying will never tell anyone what is happening.
Yeah, I just saw what happened. Are you okay?
No, I'm not. They keep on doing this. They won't leave me alone.
Have you told anyone about this?
No, what's the point? No one cares.
I care. I don't want you to feel alone. Let's go to Mr. Oden's office.
I can't. I'll miss class.
Trust me, this is more important.
Okay, I guess.
Wow. So what are the consequences of bullying?
Michigan law prohibits a person from contacting an individual with the intent to frighten or harass that person. Michigan law also prohibits using a computer or other electronic communication to cause harm to another person. A Tappan Middle School student that bullies could face detention, suspension from school, or even legal consequences if the target is severely impacted.
Hey, Mr. Oden.
Hey, Mr. Oden.
So I understand that you two have been involved in a bullying incident that ended up on Instagram. Do you guys have any idea what happens to students that are bullies? This is a situation that can get you detention. I can recommend that you guys be suspended, or depending on how bad the situation is, it can become a legal issue and the police can get involved. So what I need you two to do is to think about how you guys can make this right.
So what do we do?
Don't judge people.
Be kind and accepting.
Don't be a bystander, be an upstander.
Speak up to an adult.
Just don't bully.
Think before you post.
Ask yourself, will this hurt someone? If yes, then don't do it.
Remember, a bully-free school starts with you.